Hello and welcome to the OutPower tutorial. On this video, we'll be giving a look into asynchronous data fetching using aggregates. We'll go through a small quick example of a master detail page in a Reactive application. So with that in mind, let's go check how we can do this. Let's consider the scenario where we wish to only update a portion of information from the screen. For example, you may have a list with records, where clicking on one of them loads the detail. This is known as the master detail pattern, and this can be done by using two aggregates with different fetch properties, where the first aggregate, being the master, fetches the data immediately, and the second aggregate fetches the detail only when needed. This second set of records is loaded asynchronously, as a request takes place in the background and updates the UI when the data is received. We'll start by creating a new Reactive application, where we'll have a list of records on screen with the detail on the side. First, we create a new screen where we'll set our list and detail. Now, we'll get the list of all the records. For that, we are going to add an aggregate to our screen. But take note that we will set the fetch property with the value at start. Let's now create a detail UI that loads and shows the data detail only after selecting the record. We start this by adding a new aggregate to the screen. Still in the aggregate details pane, add a filter to the aggregate to fetch only the data for the specified ID. This forces the aggregate to return only a single record, a record that matches the selection in the list. After that, we set the fetch property of the aggregate to only on demand. With this setting, the aggregate queries the database only upon a request. Okay, now that we have established how to fetch the data, we are going to build the remaining of the screen. The detailed UI that loads data only when requested must be triggered. In this example, the app loads the data after you click the link in the list. on the list, we have a link that triggers the client action on click. Inside this action, we set the identifier of the record and refresh our aggregate that is in charge of getting the detail. Because we are using Reactive Web, the UI refreshes automatically after the data bound to it changes. Okay, now let's publish what we have done and see it in action. As you can see, as we select one record, the detail section changes, showing the relative information. Hope you have enjoyed our tutorial. Now you should be able to understand how to get data asynchronously using aggregates in a Reactive application. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial, and we hope to see you in our next video. See you soon.